Sarge speaking with Earth Walker Primitives. Welcome back to another episode of Cooking with Sarge. We're going to cook something out here. I got my tea for the day. I'm ready to go and get something to eat. So we're going to go ahead and make something with some bannock. And bannock is something that you can pre-make at home. And what bannock is, it's just flour. Now, I will say before I go ahead and talk too much about it, because someone will probably look at it and be like, well, that's not the recipe for bannock. You Google it, search it, there's thousands upon thousands of recipes for bannock out there, so I'm not trying to say this is the recipe or the best one. This is just a recipe. But bannock is something that's been around for a very long time. Some say the origins of it started in Scotland, then it moved over when the pioneers and settlers came over and passed it on to the Native Americans, and the Native Americans loved it, and they just took off with it. It's a quick, easy way to make bread out in the field when you're out camping or hiking or whatnot. And like I said, there's all different ways to make it. Some require lard and butter or milk. This method I have, the recipe for this, the version I made, is just flour, baking powder, and salt. I'll put the recipe for it up at the end of the video so you can see it. And it's just very easy. You can carry it dry, as I carry it in a tin. And then all you're going to do is you're going to add water to it. You can make it however thick you want. Some people use this just to make dumplings. They'll put it in a, they'll make it, use it like a drop biscuit or a dumpling in a soup. You can take it, you can make a dryer into like a dough, knead it into a dough, just like bread, and bake it on a board or on a rock in your fire. You can even make an ash cake where you can make it and just set it right on top of the ashes, let it cook on one side and flip it over. We're going to go ahead and make a good stiff dough, and got myself a line yogurt. We're going to go ahead and stick that on a stick and make us a little treat here. So the first thing I'm going to do, like I said, is I got my tin of bannock. Now most people see me use, most people who watch my videos see me use a pancake mix out in the field, but it's another great thing. Like I said, you can pre-make it at home and carry it with you. I just put a little bit of water in there. I'm going to start stirring it around, and I'm going to work this into a dough. Get it to a lumpy dough to where it gets to a point where I can start kneading it together. Okay, so we got our dough. Like I said, we're just kneading it into a nice little ball of dough. Bannock is definitely something that's easy to pack. It's very light. As you can see, I keep it in a tin. Some people put it in a Ziploc bag and carry it with them. You can even just use a Ziploc bag, pour your water, whatever in there. And the other great thing about bannock too is you can mix anything with it. You can even take and add sugar, cinnamon to it. You can put raisins, currants, nuts, whatever you want in it. And there's all different ways you can cook it. Even if you have a cast iron pan, a lot of people like to fry it in little cakes in their cast iron pan. So, all right, we got our dough ready to go. Like I said, we got a lanyager. This is just a German-style smoked beef. Bought at a grocery store. Go ahead and stick that in there. Make yourselves a nice little treat. You can even just take the bannock. A lot of people take bannock and just wrap it around a stick. You can just take that and hold it over to coals, and it'll cook. A little meat in my little snack here today. Go along with my tea, so I'm just going to take that bannock and just wrap it around the sausage. Of course, the meat's already cooked, so I'm just really heating the meat up as I cook the, as I bake the bannock. I'm just going to sit here now, hold that over my coals, and just let it brown, turn it around, just like if you were cooking a hot dog. We're just going to let that sit there and brown on each side, rotating to keep from burning and get a good evening cook on it. Be right back with you when it's cooked.
Go ahead.
All right, so our bannock's done being baked on our little meat there. So as you can see, it's a quick, easy way to make yourself a nice little meal out there. It's really tasty, really good. Go ahead and season it however you want. Like I said, you can put almost anything in bannock and it'll work out right for you. So I'm going to go ahead and enjoy this, finish the rest of my tea. So hope you liked the video, hope you learned something, hope you go out and try it. Sarge speaking with Earth Walker Primitives.